Yes, good morning dear students. In yesterday period we were discussed what is solution. Solution means homogeneous mixture of two or more substances, and there are two main components of a solution. First one is solvent and second one is solute. Solvent means a dissolving phase and solute means a dissolved phase. Solvent means the component of the solution that dissolves the other component in it is called the solvent, and solute means the component of the solution that is dissolved in the solvent is called the solute. And examples of solution, it means sugar solution. Sugar is the solute and water is the solvent. Afterwards, properties of solution, there are totally four properties of a solution. Afterwards, concentration of a solution, it means the amount of solute present in a given amount of a solution is termed as concentration of a solution. There are, it means concentration of a solution can be classified as two types, saturated solution and unsaturated solution. Saturated solution means a solution in which no more amount of solvent can be dissolved at a given temperature is called saturated solution. It means mass of solid divided by mass of solvent into 100. And unsaturated means if the amount of solid contained in a solution is less than the saturation level is called the unsaturated solution. It means concentration of solution is equal to amount of solute divided by the amount of solvent. Today let us see one example is given in our textbook, example 2.1 concern calculation. A solution contains 40 gram of solution contain 40 gram of common salt in 320 gram of water, gram of water. Calculate the concentration in terms of mass percentage of the solution. Yes, my dear students, it is given here. It is given a solution contains 40 gram of common salt in 320 gram of water. Calculate the concentration in terms of mass by mass percentage of the solution. It means contains water 40 gram of a common salt. Yes, in 320 gram of a water. Yes, the given data are mass of solute solution given, mass of solute is equal to 40 gram. It means it is an common salt. Yes, mass of solvent is equal to 320 gram. V solvent is used here, water. Yes, according to formula, mass of solution is equal to mass of solute plus mass of solvent. Yes, it is equal to 40 gram plus 320 gram. It is equal to 360 gram. Yes, my dear students, mass of solution is 360 gram. Next, calculate mass percentage of solution. Mass percentage of solution is equal to mass of solute divided by mass of solution into 100. Yes, mass of solute is 40, mass of solution is 360. Why 360 or 320? Because 360 plus 320 plus 40, it is equal to 360, okay, into 100. Yes, it is equal to 4000 divided by 360. After get cancellation, yes, 11.1%. It means mass percentage of a solution is equal to how much? 11.1%. Is it clear? Yes, my dear students. After discussing solved problem, let us see what is mean by suspension. What is mean by suspension? Yes. A suspension is first of all termed as what? A heterogeneous mixture in which the solid particle do not dissolve but remain suspended throughout the bulk of the medium. Yes, my dear students, heterogeneous means what? Does not have a uniform composition in which solid particle do not dissolve. It means solid does not be dissolved where? In a suspension. But remains suspended where? Throughout the bulk of the medium. Yes, definition of suspension is, a suspension is heterogeneous mixture in which the solid particles, do not dissolve but remain suspended throughout bulk of the medium. The type of a mixture is termed as what? A suspension. Yes, Examples: a mixture of chalk powder in water. It means chalk powder is does not be dissolved where in an water remain where suspended throughout the bulk of a medium. And also a mixture of sand in water. Yes, my dear students, what happen? Sand is settled down at the bottom of the container. And smoke coming out of a chimneys of a factory. Yes, example of a suspension. Example. A mixture of sand in water. A mixture of sand in water. Mixture of sand in water. Yes, my students, what happened here? Sand does not be dissolved where in an water where settle at the bottom or bulk of the container. Settle bottom of the or bulk of the container. Bulk of the container. Why? Because the density of sand is more than that of a water. Yes, my dear students, upward. Properties of suspension. Yes, suspension is termed as what? A heterogeneous mixture. Suspension, first property of suspension is it is an heterogeneous mixture. It means a mixture does not have a uniform composition. Yes, second, its particle can be seen by naked eyes. Yes, take an example. What happened? Sand in water. It means sand are seen with the help of our naked eyes. That is the second property of suspension. And third one, its particles scatter a beam of light passing through it and make its path visible. Yes, my dear students, that is termed as water Tyndall effect. It means path or bulk of the medium is seen with the help of water naked eyes. Why? A beam of light is traveled here. That is the third property of suspension. And fourth one, it is unstable. Why? The solid particle settle down when suspension is left undisturbed. They can be separated by the process of filtration. When the particle settle down, the suspension breaks and it does not scatter light anymore. Yes, my dear students, I recall one second properties of suspension. First property is suspension is termed as a heterogeneous mixture. And second property, its particle can be seen by naked eyes. Why? Because here the process of dissolving will not be takes place. Third, its particles scatter a beam of light. Why? Because of Tyndall effect. That's why a bulk of the container or path is visible. Fourth one, it is unstable. Yes, my dear students, these are the main properties of suspension. Yes. After completion of suspension, let us see what is mean by a colloidal solution. What is mean by a colloidal solution? Colloidal solution. Yes, my dear students, a colloid is a mixture that is actually heterogeneous but appears to be homogeneous as the particle are uniformly spread throughout the solution. Yes, for best example, cheese, milk. What happened, my dear students, here? Mixture is termed as what? Homogeneous, but actually it is an heterogeneous but not termed as a heterogeneous. It is an homogeneous. Why? The particles are uniformly spread throughout the solution. Yes, a colloid is a mixture that is that is actually heterogeneous, but appears to be homogeneous as the particle R uniformly spread throughout the solution. Yes, examples: milk, cheese and etc. Yes, my dear students, first of all, colloidal solutions are termed as what? A colloidal salts. It means, first of all, they are actually termed as a heterogeneous, but appears to be homogeneous as the particles are uniformly spread throughout the solution. Properties of colloids. Yes, a colloid is heterogeneous mixture. First property of colloidal is it is an heterogeneous mixture. Second, the size of a particle of a colloid is too small to be indivisible or individually seen by naked eyes. Yes, first property heterogeneous mixture. And second property is particle of a colloid is too small and seen by our naked eyes. Yes, particles are seen by our naked eyes. Third, colloids are big enough to scatter a beam of light passing through it and make its path visible. Yes, my dear students, it means a beam of light is travel where in a colloidal solution, what happened? Its path may be visible. And fourth property is the colloids are quite stable. Yes, my dear students, but suspensions are stable. Colloids are quite stable. Particle do not settle down when a colloid is left undisturbed. Yes, my dear students. What happened? The process of undisturbance takes place at the time particle do not be settled at the bulk of the container. Finally, our fifth property of a colloidal solution is particle of colloid can pass through filter paper. Therefore, a colloid cannot be separated by filtration. However, they get separated by a special technique called centrifugation. Yes, my dear students. I think all of you already see what the process of centrifugation where in a milk dairy. Yes, there the centrifugation process takes place. It means separation of water fat present in a milk. The technique is termed as what? Centrifugation. Yes, some common examples of colloids are aerosol, foam, sol, gel and solid sol. It means examples are fog, cloud, mist, smoke, automobile exhaust, shaving cream, milk, face cream, milk of magnesia, mud, rubber, sponge, fumes, jelly, cheese, butter, milk glass and colored gemstone. Yes, my dear students, these all are common examples of colloids. Yes, in today's period, we all have discussed what is mean by suspension, properties of suspension, what is a colloidal solution, and properties of colloidal solution. Thank you once again.